Well, I find it difficult really to believe. It's 10 years that you're celebrating now.
Yeah, 10 years older.
Yes. What an amazing success story. Who has guided you over those 10 years? Who's guided you along this success path?
We've guided ourselves, I should like to think. Most of the time, anyway. With the help from other people as well. Mainly, maybe, our manager, Stig Anderson.
Yeah.
It's been very important to us.
And the papers recently have been full of stories that you're going to split, eventually. You're not? No. Well, they're obviously relieved to hear it. Yeah. I was just going to ask you if that ever occurred to you and who would make the decision. I mean, would it be a joint decision?
It would, yes. Yeah. We would decide that together. It would be more of a feeling, I think, because when we were recording an album, we would feel that it's not fun anymore. We haven't got anything more to give, and that would be the time to split, you know.
Mm. You should have done that a long time ago, though.
I know.
In what way would you say you've changed since those early days of the Eurovision Song Contest?
I am alarmingly aging.
Some of the journalists in the English press says that.
You say you're alarmingly aging?
Well, am right. I really?
Do you mean musically or...?
No, as people. As people. Yeah. Do you feel that... Has it been a strain in any way?
Older and wiser, hopefully.
Are you a lot wiser? I mean, have you found that...
Yes, I am.
Oh, she's not.
Funny.
It's not
look.
Only a sexy bottom, you know.
Oh! Well, that's a quote to carry to your grave, really. I'm not just a sexy bottom, yeah. You have an LP out at the moment, the hit singles. And what I'd like to do, really, is just ask you to publicly tell us your favourite ABBA tunes. We've sorted out some tapes. And Agnetta, would you like to start? What's your favourite number from the last 10 years?
I think it... my choice will be Fernando.
Mm-hmm. For what reason?
Because I have seen on all our concerts that people seem to like this number very much. And they sing along, they clap their hands, and they can every word. It's wonderful to see.
And we get a little bit of sexy bottom as well.
Gosh. Is it necessary? They were shining there for you and me, for liberty, Fernando.
Freda, it's your choice now. Is it a difficult decision just choosing one?
Are you asking me?
Yes, it's your turn
yes,
now.
Yes, it's really.
She's getting old, isn't she?
Yeah. It's so noisy in here, you know. No, it's really a difficult decision because, I mean, Benny Bjorn has written so many good songs.
Thank you.
Yes, but you should know about that by now.
Well, you never said that.
Okay, so it's the first time.
What would you like to choose?
I would like to choose Dancing Queen. Mm-hmm. But I remember recording that backing track. I really felt something very strongly for it, you know, from my heart. And also the recording when Anna and myself did the vocals. It was something very special with that song.
At which point did you decide to grow the beard?
Well,
and I'm talking to you now.
That's about when you found out how round his face had gotten.
I mean, does it seem funny looking back at something that's, I mean, not that long ago, but it is a few years back?
Well, it's somewhat like 15 years ago I started growing a beard.
I think so.
And Bjorn is right. That's why I keep it.
He looks like a little cherub without it, doesn't he? Isn't he?
You should ask him the same question later. Yeah.
Benny, a selection, please. A choice.
Yeah, that's difficult. I'll pick Chiquitita.
For what reason?
Well, I think it's one of our best songs. I think all four of us here will pick. It's four numbers, and I think they all four will go. Yes. Chiquitita, you and I know.
So, finally to the oldest one. Bjorn, can we have a choice?
I'll pick the newest one then. I'll pick The Winner Takes It All partly because I was told this was to be my choice.
Quite right.
But
you know the reason?
Most of all.
The reason for that is because it's my favourite one and because I wanted it on regardless.
Yeah, okay. Okay.
So that's why you're lumbered with it.
Yeah. But anyway, it definitely is one of my favourites. I think it's got a beautiful, haunting melody, a brilliant, intelligent lyric, about two lovers parting.
And it earned you a lot of money as well.
It did, yeah.
Now it's history. I played all my cards, and that's what you've done too. Nothing more to say, no more ace to play. The winner takes it all, the loser standing small beside the victor.
We had to stop it before we get to the best bit, simply because we actually want them to have a go at doing a little bit of live music here. Just before ABBA play us out from this edition of the show, can I remind you that I'll have as my guests next week Fleetwood Mac and the incredible Diana Ross. We've also got Kevin Munn, a viewer who's got a chance to come in and meet ABBA. Could we possibly have a little bit of music from you? Don't look like that as if it's a
really?
Surprise. Please don't walk out. We'd like you to play us out of the programme. Kevin, do come in. Come over here.
So grateful and proud. All I want
guessing what they were doing. They ran the credits over, played it out nicely.
Thank you.
Yes. I think it was picked up on the boom, all right. I think it was very good. Okay.